Health Canada has a warning out for a drug usually prescribed for acid reflux or other stomach troubles. The medication is called domperidone. And CBC medical specialist Dr. Carl Cabasel is here to talk specifically about this.
Yeah.
It's a warning that, first walk me through that warning and who should really be aware of it.
Absolutely. So in particular, they're talking about people over the age of 60 who are taking this drug, or people who take more than 30 milligrams per day. Mm-hmm. The warning is that there have been incidents of arrhythmias of the heart and sudden cardiac death in people who, in those two categories.
So arrhythmia of the heart is palpitations?
Palpitations, it beats out of order and therefore it's not properly providing blood to the body and specifically the brain.
So if you're over 60 and you've got this in your medical cabinet, what do you do?
Well, you talk to your doctor. You don't just abruptly stop it. You talk to your doctor about it and see if maybe there are some other ways to deal with your problem. Mm-hmm. And so we should say domperidone is usually prescribed, as you said, for the gastrointestinal system. Mm-hmm. And particularly when things slow down, it's a drug that helps to get things moving again. So an example is people with diabetes who have what we call gastroparesis, which is a neurologic problem where the stomach isn't emptying properly. Mm-hmm. This drug will help that to happen. If you don't use the drug, then you get nausea, things start to back up, and you get very uncomfortable. So it can be a very helpful drug in those situations.
It's also being prescribed. Is it off-label? Is that what doctors say, off-label, being prescribed for what? Lactating women?
Well, that's right. So one of the side effects of domperidone is it increases prolactin, which is a hormone that helps in the lactation process.
Right.
And in some cases, as you said, off-label, because it's not approved for this purpose.
Okay.
But it can be prescribed to help women to lactate if they're having trouble in that area.
But if you're over 60, you don't want to lactate.
Well, yeah, that's a different problem. But the other category we talked about, those using more than 30 milligrams a day, if someone's going to be prescribed domperidone for lactating, it'll probably be more than that. So they fall into this category
as well. Right, which is why the amount of the dosage really matters.
That's
right,
regardless of your age.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So advice for those who are taking this, walk me through it again. You mentioned go see your doctor, right?
Well, yeah. So here's the thing. Don't just stop it
if
you're not having any symptoms. But if you feel dizzy, lightheaded, like you're going to pass out, or palpitations, your heart sort of pounding, and you're on domperidone, you should stop it immediately and seek immediate medical attention.
Mm-hmm.
You see the difference there? And, of course, if you're taking it for lactation, off-label, through your doctor, there are other things you can do other than taking a medication if you feel that you're not producing enough milk.
I thought, have a beer.
Well,
is that wrong?
I
know I did. I had somebody said have a beer, it increases lactation.
Yeah, it's
I
one
said,
of those.
Sure,
it's one of those natural remedies. You know, the problem is, of course, that alcohol travels through the breast milk to the baby.
Right.
Not really advisable. But just behavioral things, making sure the baby has a good latch on the nipple, making sure the baby doesn't have nipple confusion. So if the baby's drinking from a bottle and from the breast, it's so much easier to drink from the bottle that they're not putting in the required effort at the breast, for example. You have to look for underlying medical conditions in both mother and baby to see if there's a reason why the transfer of milk is not happening properly. And, you know, stress, things as simple as stress can make it difficult for a woman to produce enough milk.
Mm-hmm.
We also have to look at her nutrition. Is she getting enough protein? Is she getting enough fluids in her diet? All of these things, before we jump to drugs, all of these things should be examined. And hopefully that will help with the lactation problem.
You know what's shocking here is getting it wrong. Yet we talk about domperidone today. We talked about other stories this week. And who knows what's coming up in the month ahead. But, you know,
this is true. But you know what? This is a sign that the system works. So before a drug is released, it's evaluated for safety.
Mm-hmm.
But that evaluation continues as the drug is on the market. And this one's been on the market for years and years, since the 80s. But as soon as something comes to our attention, we put it out there and the warnings go out there.
Great to have you on, Carl. Thank you.
Thank you.
CBC medical specialist, Dr. Carl Cabasel.